now.
Terraflora's cancers at the planet-shaped cheese ball cup. They signed some good crumble whackers in the off-season.
Excuse me?
No worries.
Wow! Wow!
do. I'm a jump!
Growth. Huh?
Of the Everbloom tree itself. We mean you no harm. In fact, we can help restore your majestic Everbloom to its natural efflorescing state. Of course, oh great spirit of the Everbloom. Thank you. You won't regret it.
Wait.
Ah!
it!
The warden here is Bea? It turns out she's the Bea, the beloved singer who left it all behind to become an organic farmer. She got her start playing Roxy on the Gachapon Gang, a show about a teen rock band who turned into giant gachapons to fight crime. Bea's first solo album was corporate-produced teen pop drivel. I mean, really, who listens to that rubbish?
Your playlist has 6 different live versions of this album, including a remastered one that was released last week, Beepo.
Her manager and made an experimental album done entirely underwater. Critics dared to call it an artistic temper tantrum appealing only to pseudo-intellectual snobs. Honestly, I loved it. is a survivor. With her singing career over, she retired to Terra Flora and began a new life as an organic farmer. Thankfully, we have lots of great albums to remember Bia's beautiful voice. Just not this one. Yeah, she sounds like a rusty chainsaw.
Of. A chuff, a puff, a gasp. Can you?
Ah!
Beepo or Rambling Rabbit Luigi? Good times.
Thank you.
Generation of fans was exposed to Mia when she became a celebrity host for the annual Galactovision Song Contest. Unfortunately, the Phantom was her co-host. The two constantly tried to outshine each other, eventually ruining their voices. Bia sang the Beacon Beach Brawler's entrance music live for his Galaxy Wrestling title bout at Galactomania. It was the first of many ill-advised comeback attempts, although she did develop one heck of a sunset pile driver. This album during her punk pop phase after a whirlwind relationship with the Phantom. Silly celebrity nonsense, really. I can't believe he dumped her at the Galaxy Music Awards by text during her acceptance speech. I'll never forgive him.
Fly!
We have yet to meet a warden who did not fascinate, and Terra Flora's Bia is no exception. A popular entertainer since a tender young age, when her career came to a halt, she could have wallowed in excess or let bitterness consume her. Instead, she reinvented herself as a flower farmer whose bouquets make hearts swell all over the galaxy, just as her music once did.
More mature Bia grew into her own with this album, which critics called soulful and masterfully crafted. It sold only 300 copies and effectively ended her career.
Ah! Oh, yeah!
Spirit of the Everbloom?
Oh, honey.
If you're the warden, you must know where we can find the darkness that's infiltrated Terra Flora.
Mount Spout. Oh. Flowers, flowers. My sweet.
Upgraded. I see why you called him Drizzle. He certainly made a splash with me.
Drizzle? Our flowers. Sugar.
Oh.
Terraflora, what now?
Wow.
Ha! Open it!
Monstrous absurdities!
It's a mobile advert for Terraflora's superior infusion, the top-selling negativity cleanser and wealth manifestation tea. I'm pretty sure it's the only tea sold on Terraflora, but still, I hear it removes the subconscious mental blocks that cause baldness.
Oh.
Yeah!
Of this darkness puddle reveals a lot of frantic activity within. Hey, your infectious lethargy would make you an ideal candidate to calm the enemy down a little, no?
Whoa!
You're clever.
Thank you.
Ran the table. Ha! Yo yo. Got one.
At long last.
Sullivan, about the Dark Mist tentacle on the tracks.
Whoa! Don't worry.
Thank you.
On Terra Flora, we became acquainted with the Terra Flora railway system, which connects its central station to the base of Mount Spout and is run by its charming conductor, Sullivan. Some consider steam trains to be antiquated, but the train on Terra Flora operates in harmony with its floral surroundings. It is a masterpiece of engineering.
Fear thee not.
Yes, yes, that's great, but can we focus on the dark mist tentacle on the tracks instead of your shock absorbers, please?
All aboard!
Choo-choo!
Okay.
Aha! Aha! Come on! There you go.
That's it.
Hey. 1, 2, 4.
Mm-hmm.
Wretched fate! My steamy!
Right, well, thank you for...
Cruel desire. Personal growth.
Eloquent, proficient, and passionate, Sullivan is the chief train engineer on Terra Flora. But for him, it is no mere job. He is a lover of all things mechanical, and has a strong attachment to his beloved steam train, which he cares for with a tender hand. After his train, there is his timetable. He takes pride not just in being punctual, but in being someone the rabbits of Terra Flora can count on.
Up. What can be done? Oh.
Allow us to help then. We'll visit each thorn at its source and remove them one by one. It's the least we can do.
Valiant champions!
Thank you.